a more better way of writing that fraction. Most best. Okay? So, just for repetition purposes, what would this be? Say it together. Okay, love the enthusiasm. Negative 2x plus 3y over positive 7. We change all the signs. Okay? Any questions on that? That's just something you need to get used to doing. Okay? Can't have I down there. If I make it an even power, then I'm good. So what do I need to do? Multiply by one more I. This gives me 5i to the fourth power. Okay, let's concentrate on I to the fourth power and think about what we did at the very beginning. 2 goes into 4? 2, an even number of times. So is that going to be plus 1 or minus 1? Plus 1. So this is 5 times 1, which is just 5. Okay? All right, now I said it's just like radicals. What did we do when we had this type of situation with the radical in the denominator? We multiply by the same thing but minus instead of plus. So 2 minus 4i in the numerator and denominator. We're going with the concept of the difference of perfect squares, the inner and outer terms will cancel each other out. You will not have an I left. In the numerator, we have a distribution. 3i times 2 will be 6i. What's 3i times negative 4i? Negative 12i squared. We'll come back to that. In the denominator, first times first is 4. Your inner and outer terms give you plus 8 and minus 8, which is 0. And your last terms give you negative 16i squared. Okay. We got to work on anything that, any I that has something bigger than a power of 1. Well, right here, what is I squared? So this is negative 12 times negative 1. And this is negative 16 times negative 1. Too much. What's negative 12 times negative 1? What's negative 16 times negative 1? Plus 16, right? And 4 plus 16 is? 20. Does everybody see how I got all that? Does anybody have a question?
Can you reduce the 12 and 20?
Yes. Not just the 12 and the 20. Because there are three terms in this thing. This is 6 over 20 and 12 over 20. And we want to keep it as a single fraction. So if all three of these terms can be reduced by the same number, it has to be the same number, then we'll reduce them. What's the biggest number that goes into 6, 12, and 20? 2. So I'm going to reduce them all by 2. And I make sure I don't have a negative denominator, which I don't. All terms have to be reduced by the same thing. Does to solve equations that contain only an x squared term. Okay, we're going to get into tomorrow using factoring to solve quadratic equations. But right now I'm talking about when your equation just has x squared and no other term has an x in it. The first thing we need to look at is this. Negative 2 squared and positive 2 squared. Do they both equal the same thing? They both equal 4, right? So if I said x squared is equal to 4, what is x? It could be positive 2 or it could be negative 2, right? So what we're getting into right now is when you have an equation where you get to this point, remember, we always want to undo what's happening to x. What's happening to x? It's being squared. How do you undo squaring? You take the square root. If you've got to take the square root of both sides because of this fact right here, we automatically know we have two solutions. We have a positive solution and we have a negative solution. So automatically you're going to put plus or minus. That's very, very important, okay? You've got to show that it's both positive 2 could answer this, because 2 squared is 4, and negative 2, because negative 2 squared is also 4. All right? Okay, now let's look. 4x squared plus 64 equals 0. If I wanted you to find out what is x, automatically, because there's an x squared term, you should know there's two solutions. Okay? Because there's two x's in there. All right? Let's just imagine it was just x, and I wanted to figure it out. We're going to try to isolate this, right? So the first thing we're going to do is subtract 64 from both sides. Then we're going to divide both sides by 4. Okay? Now this is why we did the whole imaginary stuff. Because now, to undo squaring something, I'm going to take the square root of both sides, but I'm dealing with the square root of a negative number, which is not a real solution, but there is a complex or imaginary solution. Because I took the square root of both sides, the first thing I need to show is x equals what? Plus or minus. Automatically. Plus or minus. All right, now we did this at the very beginning. How do you simplify the square root of negative 16? You got the I, and then what's the square root of 16? 4. So x is equal to positive 4i. And x is equal to negative 4i. Yes?
I don't understand what you're supposed to do. It's whenever, it's the very first thing we did. And if we did this, if we broke it down into this, and that's what the term is.
Okay, because in our final answer, when you're working with problems with I in them, you don't want to worry about reducing them to the very end. And in your final answer, you cannot have any exponent on the I other than 1. So if it's bigger, if it's I squared, you've got to simplify it. Okay. Well, I to the 16th power means, because we know definitely that I squared is something specific. So we're trying to figure out how many of these specific things do we have. Well, this is undoing a power to a power. Okay, I have 8 groups of 2 in 16. Well, that means I have a negative 1 multiplied by itself 8 times. So it's positive 1. Okay. So anytime your final answer has an exponent here, you want to reduce it. You don't want to have an exponent on your I. It's either going to go away. When does it go away? When the exponent is